Alright. Is there anything else in here? I don't think so. I think that was the end of the map too. How did we get in, actually? Is there a door? I don't remember. Nope, that's not it.
Yes.
But I can
downward
talk to the librarian. You go. And I'll teleport you.
Well, hello there. Until we meet again.
Inventory, what is the R?
Well, hello there. Until we meet again.
Yeah, sure.
Nothing happened.
Right, there is nothing else here. Shit. There is the path on the other side where it was the
spiders and the sandstorm.
Yeah, with all the my god, animals.
There is also the Troll King cave.
We don't know the password, but I think we have the key now also. But let's go here. I want to see if there is something we can do.
Always with this stuff.
Something. Jesus. Is it really 1 o'clock? Jesus. Alright.
When last we left the deathly hag, she hovered over the counselor's deathbed among the throng of his beloved, watching, waiting, vials of purple.
Ah, what a pleasant sight!
I shall now sing the story of Astarte, revered goddess of the source. Oh, how mighty, yet oh, how fallen. Astarte was born of the godflower soon after the coming of night.
Tis the story of Astarte.
And within a week of her birth, source had formed inside her. A strange thing happened then. And everything that lived felt better. Strange, yes,
listener. What the hell is the... What?
Stronger were they made by source. Faster were they made by source. They glowed in health, and they felt in joy. Astarte thus was loved. Man came then, and he grew knowing only Astarte's love, the many ways to give it and receive it. It was a love of...
Can you stop?
But, like all love affairs, it was soon spotted by doom, and its days were quickly numbered on doom's dreadful fingers. In time, as must everyone, Astarte faltered. How she fell and why, we know not, but we know that suddenly source was changed. Those who would heal had to kill to do it. Those who attempted to meditate upon source, those who would once commune with the goddess, went mad. Where did the goddess go? Only the divines know. Her temples alone remain. Her temples and the sick source that plagues us now. Oh, how mighty. Oh, how fallen.
Pleasure repeats. Hello.
Mm-hmm.
His voice never works. Deathly hag. Or music. Hear his music or voice, I never hear it. Watching,
waiting, really? Of you don't hear him speaking?
Kirill, not from Albini.
Cloaked was she in a
wallflower charm. Look at
unseen was she by the groups of maids and husbands and children that would surely shriek if they saw her.
Boy then. Look who's back. Boy then.
His voice works, but I don't hear anything. Now he plays.
She tipped it close, and the room's guests gasped, and the council.
I hear nothing of music.
Right. You don't hear that? No.
Nope. Actually, there's no music playing at all.
Right. It's weird. So we need to go. There is a. Ah, the Michaelis, sorry. Have we done anything? Everything? There is some white here, yeah, let's explore it.
There is a goblin camp.
Well, hello,
where then. I am, and the goblin is green, so I guess
stand there. Back, puny human, or I shall sear you with the eternal flames of the mighty drog. Fear the wind of my wings, quiver before the might of my razor talons. You're a bunny, dude. Flames, wings and talons, eh? You don't look much of a dragon to me. Blasphemy, do you imperfect eyes fail to recognize my true nature? The rabbit I may be without, but the dragon I remain within. If you're a dragon, why are you in a rabbit's body? Even an eternal creature of legend and myth needs a vacation from the limelight now and then. Sometimes it does one good to hop about among the clover without once every waking moment remembering Soger's story. Good luck to you, Sir Rabbit Dragon. Be gone, weakling.
Until we meet again.
Wait. See anything here? A camp with some
now,
people.
Now, brown cow. Ha! Donnie would have been in stitches.
I don't understand why you're still put. Silverglen can't be far away now, can it?
The goblins here is home as thick as flies around me, cattle larses. Put an axe in my bodyguard's face, one of them did, right where his big drinker nose used to be. So you wish to partake in a polite little parley about our respective prospects, purposes and expectations in life, do you? Bloody red nonsense that. I am Roy, I'm in the animal trade, and instead of knocking back cheap rye in Silverglen, I'm stuck in a freaking forest surrounded by totem worshipping savages and want to use my privates for target practice. There, you know it all. Nice animals, hi, my latest sets for measure ties, joy to hear them a lot, until they crap all over your shoes, that is. Won't cost me fortunes on boot black's wedges, much longer though. Bought them for cheap from Berta back in the city, and about to sell them dearly, indeed, in Sacred Stone, good luck with that. Full of lunatics that please, or so I've been told, they'll slice those bits from ear to ear. Yeah, alright. Tell me about your bodyguard, Donny, bah, some thug from Sicel he was. Do you remember a Donny?
Nope.
Me neither. All balls, no brains, you know. Perfect set of qualities to lead me past the zombies I figured. Figured right I did, until we met them goblins. Now you can have bollocks bigger than the bull over there, but it takes a fair bit of wit and cunning to be the goblin at a hunting game. And Donny, I tell you, the simple soul, would have believed you if you told him eggs grew on eggplants. Alright. Perhaps you need an escort out of here. Oh, you'll provide protection, will you? Be my paladin, my knight in shining armor? Like hell you will. You with your fancy weapons and armor, you rattle like a gypsy's wagon. Every damned goblin between here and freaking moon will hear you coming. No, no. I'll get out of here soon enough by my bloody self. Well, fuck you then.
Wait. Until we meet again.
Well, hello there.
A sunny day to you. Delighted to make your acquaintance. Please tell me about yourselves. Your interest in my modest person truly flatters me. My name is Doreen, and this is my husband, my flame, my love, my Valentine, Maurice. Moo. Yeah, Maurice, darling, do be quiet. He never bothered to master human tongue, you see? And is therefore wholly incapable of indulging in this delightful conversation. Moo. Yes, yes, that'll do, Maurice. He's just so exciting, you know, as I am to go to the golden pastures of Silverglen. Laroi, an owner, has been going on and on about how all of us will soon be in a better place indeed. you do know you are to be slaughtered in Silverglen, don't you? Dear me, slaughtered? This cannot be. We must do something. Maurice, darling, do something. Ooh. It's late for that, isn't it? Trust you to raise a moot point, Maurice. Oh, kind human, have mercy on us poor animals. Deliver us from certain death in horrid silver green.
Until we meet again.
What happened to that guy?
He was chasing a rabbit.
You don't just stand there ruminating. Let's go, 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 mate.
My friend returns.
All right.
Until we meet again.
Let's talk to him and see if we can do something.
Well, hello there.
These animals are destined to be slaughtered. Hadn't you released them? What? You're soft of heart, are you? The poor dear...
Wait a minute. Ambrose, Ram... the beauty of the Doreen that is sweet may... Wow. Okay. The... sip is hot on the cow. So you pass the Doreen, do you? Why yes, do tell me, have you ever beheld a bovine bale as elegant as her? No, for such a cow does not exist. Would that I could partake in the privilege that boar of a bull enjoys. How cute and woolly our offspring will be.
Until right. We meet again.
Now go.
You're soft of heart, are you? The poor deer shouldn't be killed. I should just give up on the gold they'll fetch me? Well, say no more. Seriously, shut it. You think I risked my life and limb for a bit of beef and mutton? Either you pay me in gold, or you leave me alone before all this chatter attracts the damned goblins.
Sure, how much?
What if I was to pay for these animals? They're yours for the money I was gonna ask them for Bloody Bankless in Sacred Stone. It will be 1300 gold.
That's cheap. That is cheap. But Kreia would say, why would you save these animals? Their lot is to be slaughtered if they can't survive by themselves. But since we are not Jedi's, or Sith, pick something.
No, that's a bit rich for my blood. Fair enough, you have a deal. Okay.
Yep. I have 20k, I have no issue with that.
Wonderful, yes, come, hand me that gold. Give it here, yes. They're yours now, and I'm legging it
creepy.
Back to
the scene.
Until we meet again.
My friend returns.
The hero of the hour, nay, the century. How agreeable it is to gaze upon you. You are free from Roy, you are safe. My champion, I mean your debt. Maurice and I are infinitely grateful. May neither thine horns nor thine udders ever wither. Moo. Well said, my dear Maurice, well spoken indeed. But what shall we do next? We can hardly travel with you now, can't we? Kind hero. Perhaps we should seek those legendary pastures that nasty creature of a Roy described. They may well be real, for a man such as he hasn't the imagination to dream up such a lovely place. Though perhaps it's safer to and more convenient simply to return to Asir.
Yes, I can tell them to follow the dream, I say.
Yes, I see.
Those postures.
I can actually see now, I think they patched it, and I can actually see the answers on the multiplayer conversations.
Really good.
Which makes sense.
Should I tell them to follow the dream? They go back to Sicily, gonna slaughter them again, I guess.
Yeah, they're gonna die anyway, so follow your dream until you die. Everyone dies.
Of course.
Life lessons by Costas. You are all going to die. Okay, Butcher was reading the book a few days ago. Anyway, yes, I had hoped you could say that. Oh, this is dizzying exciting. Maurice, Dumbling, let us embark on a thrilling adventure forthwith.
Until we meet again.
You want, but I'm not interested. Later, mates.
The Bunny doesn't care. And Bruce doesn't care either. Alrighty.
What have you got stashed in here, Mrs. Cottontail?
Ah, it's up here. Cool. Right. Let's hope they make it.
There are some trolls down here. There are goblins on the left and trolls down.
Alright. We'll go both places.
Amadeus and Archibald.
Amadeus. Jesus. How old is that song?
Pretty old.
Alrighty, let's do this.
Seems like these trolls have been busy of late. Shit.
They must be powerful indeed to overcome so many.
Look!
And humans both.
One of alien aspect approaches. Go on, my boy. State the ancient demand. Tall troll. Okay. Well, I correct my son, but not quite. Troll. You come very close in your approximation of the venerable big, my boy, but a tiny flaw distorts it still. Troll. Okay. Capital, my son. Most excellent. I'm very proud of you indeed. Now then, dearest wanderer of Lucullus' leaf-strewn lanes, you have heard our inviolable command. Pay us trolls.
It's a very articulate troll.
Yep. That is affirmative, and the bridge shall be yours to cross. Who are you two? I am Bridgekeeper Archibald. Right. And this wee cherub is my dear son, Amadeus. I am in charge of this, of his education. And we'll see to it that one day he shall become the greatest bridgekeeper ever to have voiced the hallowed tenet, Troll Toll. Yes, so he shall indeed. I have some other questions. What happened to those dead travelers? Those clubbed unfortunates over yonder? They did not pay the toll, traveler. And to be clubbed, I'm afraid, is the fate that indubitably befalls those who do not heed the infrangible doctrine that is Troll Toll.
Already?
The most educated troll ever. Anyway, why must we pay a toll? Because our king deems it equitable that we should do so. His word is law among us trolls, and by extension, anyone who travels through these lands, the woods of Lugula. Let's discuss the Troll King. They say only one of your kind has ever met him, and even that is but a rumor. Maradino is the name this exception went by, a sorcerer.
Maradino, yes, we haven't found him yet.
No, you. So quick that grimace on sorcerer of eccentric character.
Aha, right. I got that. Understood that reference. good.
I was told he had a letter upon Luke's desert plain, but I never seen proof myself. All for the better. Should he have stood in the presence of the king, his presence would have been snapped decisively and brutally.
Bang. I should have gotten leadership if it gives 10% damage bonus for every point.
I think I can get some leadership, I'm not sure.
That's kinda insane.
With a bang indeed, Amadeus, let's discuss the toll. Now then, my boy, please acquaint our aspirant bridge crosser with the quantity of the toll that must pay. The toll is 1,000,000 gold coins. Oh my god. Indeed it is not, Amadeus, as you very well know. Greed is a vice, my son. It is a vulture most vile that preys on virtue. Cast it from your soul and restate the pecuniary levy We desire with all your hearts of honesty. 1,350 coins.
Sure, why not?
I suppose this must pay.
Let's not kill the guy and his son.
Mothers.
Obedient.
Indeed, have been most courteous and forthcoming. Now then, what do we say, my boy, to the kind traveler who has sufficiently disbursed us? We say thank you. So, thank you, traveler. But, Daddy, this is such a bore. I want to clap some more. Okay, Amadeus.
Amadeus, you need
Amadeus.
Lessons.
That's a bore. I want to clap some more. Have you been talking to that ne'er-do-well of a Belegar again? Please do forgive.
Oh my god, Belegar.
He's everywhere.
Fuck you, Belegar.
I shall have a sound word with this wee rapscallion indeed. In the meantime, do feel free to cross the bridge. All true thanks you have wholeheartedly.
Yes. Let's go talk to the goblins. And also have now plus one to willpower when I am close to leader. You do, obedient, you do.
Nice.
We need to raise that, I keep forgetting.
Oh, it's no care for skinny. Work he can, so gold them will give us.
Gold, aye. Enough to buy myself another human for cooking.
If you want Uman for cooking, why not use this? I told you he was but a mangy one.
Where do you get leadership? For skills?
No.
Personality? No.
Yeah, personality, leadership. Plus one from gear.
Alright, I'm blind. I'll put one more to Madora.
If you put one to Madora and I put one in mine, do they combine?
I don't think so. Oh, got a chance to hit plus 10% too. So instead of another damage, we get 10% to hit. And the rest. That's nice. Maybe I will raise that to Madora. Alright. Let's save and go talk to this guy.